everyone. Today we are at the Science Center in Paris. Are you excited, Ella?
Yeah.
You doing a dance?
No, not really. I'm just doing my
dance. I saw you doing a dance. We're excited for this episode. We're gonna do so much stuff in this new Science Center that we never explored before, right, Ella?
Yeah.
What we wanna do the most is go to the arcade that's supposed to be in there. I think it's like old games or whatever, right?
Right.
Yeah, we're gonna have so much fun. There's the planetarium where it's like an 8K video dome. So we're gonna go do that. It's gonna be a lot of fun, so join us in this episode. Have a lot of family fun learning and an awesome field trip with us.
I hope you have Street Fighter.
What?
You guys ready? Let's do this. All right, so this is our first part that we're visiting.
I am a dragon. I am a dragon.
Ella's a dragon.
I'm flying.
It says, observe the shape of their heads, count their legs. Can you see how shiny their wings are? But they didn't always look like this. Lift the lid to see the larvae, and that like living in the dark.
Yeah!
Are you just yelling out loud?
Look. Can you speak? Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Speak.
Hey, wait, where's Leo? Why is Leo here?
Oh, you made me sound like Leo.
Wow. Press these buttons.
Hey, why do I sound like Leo all of a sudden?
You sound like a boy.
Oh, that's crazy. I sounded like Leo. I was like, is Leo talking to me? My God, that's so crazy.
You're talking to the mic. Hello?
Hello? So what we have here is it's showing you that a salamander, which is the end, starts with an egg, and then it turns to a larva, and then it turns to an axolotl, and then metamorphosis changes it into a salamander.
Oh, an axolotl is a salamander in the end. I didn't know that.
We got seeds.
It's right here.
Seedlings, adult plant, and flowering. So seedlings are over there in that corner in that mirror. Oh yeah, I see some seeds there. Okay. So you got your, which this one?
That one?
Yeah.
It's this one.
And then this one is that one?
It's that one.
Okay, and that one's the
this one's
adult plant?
One.
What's that one? Flowering adult plant.
It's
why is it flowering, Hugo? What do you see?
Flowers.
Buds. Oh. See the buds? Those are flowering.
Beware of the shadows behind you. It slips into the dark corners, invites you to play with it, whispers secrets in your ear, but the light can be deceptive. So don't always trust what you see. Silhouettes on a wall may seem familiar, but in the blink of an eye, bodies can mutate. Wings sprout here, claws there. Animals and humans combined, and monsters are born. We all have a little dark place in our hearts. Stop being afraid of the dark. Sometimes we just have to accept it. So come closer and plunge into the darkness. Let
the brain try it. Yep, no magnet. It's saying no.
I know which one will have magnet. Tomato soup.
Is it? Let's see. Yep. The soup is magnetic?
No, the can.
Oh, the can. I was so confused.
Qu'une image n'est enregistrée, je vais simplement te montrer comment je fais. Alors, ça, donc, c'est toi. Pour reconnaître tes émotions, j'utilise la position de tes yeux, de ta bouche et de tes sourcils. Essaie de faire un grand sourire pour voir.
You're mostly sad.
Oula, c'est de la tristesse que je vois sur ton visage. Je n'aime pas te voir triste. Si je n'étais pas bloqué ici, je te ferais un gros câlin.
I'm in space!
Wow, this is a sound light. You know what that is? That gives us like TV, internet, yes.
Yeah, I know what it is. Can I tell you the place?
Guys, there are space rumbas here.
Wow, look at here.
I want to show you something.
It's like making it seem like you're on the moon. You know why? This section is popular. Look. Wow, and look at here. You can see it from another perspective. The spaceship.
You have to walk like you're in space.
Wait, like this? Oh, well, that's...
that's how Michael Jackson moves.
How do you walk in space there? You can't do that here.
If you live in the moon with me, would you just play Fortnite all day?
Right there, yeah.
I guess Mommy wouldn't have to bring you camping anymore.
Because we could camp right there.
Mm-hmm.
Or, well, our house is technically a tent.
Wow.
There's only one, though.
Wow.
It's an illusion that makes it look like more, I think.
Yeah, it's mirrors.
See?
But this is the idea, right?
Mm-hmm.
If there's a space garden, this is how it's going to look like.
Yeah, it's a type of rover, Perseverance, like...
Agency NASA, rover for the Mars 2020 mission. Destination Mars, launch 2020. Objective, study the surface of Mars and collect samples. Status, mission underway.
Cool. What's that?
Attention. Attention.
Wow, that's a really wide screen, Hugo. Is it PS5, Hugo, or Xbox? PC?
We're going to the aquarium section now of the Science Center. Wow, look at the lips, it's so unique.
They don't care if look. You boop it. See, they don't care if you boop it.
As long as you don't tap on the glass.
There's a little model there of the actual submarine we're gonna go inside.
Guys, the propeller isn't right, just saying.
Yeah, it's not solid like that. Actually, it's pretty accurate, man. It just wasn't golden. Maybe it was golden originally. The Argonaut was built in the Chernobyl Naval Base in 1953. That's a long time ago. And it entered activity service in October 1958 in the midst of the Cold War. And by the way, the Cold War means that they weren't actually fighting with guns. They were more fighting with each other politically, as in with feelings. The Soviet fleet consisted mainly of submarines. To track them discreetly, the West needed to design a small, maneuverable, and quiet submarine. In order to avoid detection, all of the engines on board the Argonaut were mounted on elastic suspensions so as not to transmit vibrations to the hull. The Argonaut was also the subject of other innovations, in particular for its diesel engines, which are now used only to recharge batteries, which means it's now battery powered. Having sailed for 25 years mainly in the Mediterranean without engaging in any combat, the Argonaut made it to its last voyage from Toulon via Le Havre Harbor to Paris, where it welcomed its first visitors in December 1990. It is this pioneering role and its presence in the capital that earned the Argonaut the status of historical monument in 2019. The captain right there.
And storage space.
It's the captain right here. Chilling.
He's
chilling.
Here.
He's chilling.
This is where they sleep. sleep here.
Oh, this is where they chill. This is officer's cabin. This is the...
This is wardrobe.
That's the commanding officer cabin. Whoa.
He gets this lucky boy right here. And yeah, that's pretty cool. So this is the ballast tanks. The ballast tanks are wrapped around the pressure hull of the submarine. They act as reservoirs that are open at the bottom of the passing underneath the Argonaut. You can see these openings on each side, running the length of the submarine. So that seawater can be quickly filled or emptied. Ah, cool. To be able to maneuver underwater, a submarine must weigh exactly the same as the volume of the water it displaces. This is Archimedes' principle. But it must also be able to maneuver at the surface. For this, it needs to achieve buoyancy. This is the role of the ballast tanks. When they are filled with water, the submarine dives. To resurface, they are emptied using pressurized air.
Oh, that's so cool.
It is.
Here.
Oh, here. I'm pointing the wrong places. And over here is like a, I guess, like a blowhole, like a whale. Air blow system.
Because look at this one. This is when it's closed.
Yeah.
Right? And then air fills. And this is when it's open and then water fills.
Ah, that's cool.
Pressurized air supply. See?
You know, I knew none of this before this trip. So now I know about submarines.
Oh look, it says no ballast tanks, no submarine.
No ballast tanks, no submarine. So without the air held in the ballast tanks, you cannot raise a submarine, which makes sense because you must decrease the pressure to bring the submarine upwards by filling with air.
This is why we go to the science center, so that we learn about things. No. And we're learning a lot about submarines.
Mommy, I'm not squishy.
The Argonaut belongs to the French Navy and was in service from 1958 to 1982. Its propulsion is diesel-electric. Its length is nearly 50 meters, and it could dive to a depth of 200 meters. It was manned by a crew of 40. Maneuverable, fast, and very unobtrusive underwater, the Argonaut mainly carried out surveillance missions. It covered a total of 210,400 nautical miles, 10 times the distance around the world. Very innovative in its day, it can now be visited at the Cité des Sciences et de l'Industrie.
Need 125
rods
for that one.
That is not the right control. Descend 20 meters. Oh, work it out. Work out, Hugo. Work out, work out. What is he doing? What is he doing? Increase the screw power. 7 knots. 7 knots. Show how you can conduct as a wire using your body. You alright, Ella? You doing it right?
No.
No? Okay. Let's see what you got, Ella.
Maybe you should try.
How about that one?
A woman?
Is it? Cool.
A lady? That is me.
Yeah.
It looks like a bald man. It is a bald man.
Okay.
Mommy, I got the look right. It is a bald man.
Whoa, you are fast as that.
Right. To the east, 20 degrees.
Good job!
Good job. First try!
Oh,
it's a big giant. Yeah, it's a sound bouncer.
I can actually hear you!
What?
This is like a big satellite dish.
I'm very sharp.
Yeah.
Lion.
Can I try?
I know what you're doing. You have eight tentacles.
Hello! Hello, okay. What about this one?
Give me the game. I'm enjoying the movie.
This one, Sprint. Oh wait, what is this one? Oh, Portugal. Let's do Philippines. I know these countries. Okay, what about this one?
Please, you're welcome.
Like they say it like that, please, you're welcome. Oh, here.
No,
what is it?
Why don't we just listen to it? I can't say it.
Oh my god. That does not sound Japanese. Okay, what about this one? This one's Korea. That's Korea. Okay, what about this one? We had so much fun! Yay, this science center is awesome. I hope you liked the videos. I hope you learned a lot. And when you come here, you'll enjoy it just as much as we enjoy it. Until next time, like and subscribe if you had fun. And we'll see you soon. Bye.